detecting harmful organic compounds in the environment, regulating the solar heat gain through windows, storing heat in your house, using sunlight to convert carbon dioxide into valuable chemicals and fuels. These are just some of the challenges faced by TNO's Material Solutions Research Group. Each of our five technology programs, geoenergy, energy conversion and storage, sustainable buildings, additive manufacturing and lightweight automotive, focuses on the transition to sustainable energy and sustainable materials. As a group, our strength lies in our long-standing track record in multifunctional polymer materials, polymer composites, nanoparticles, and wet chemical coatings. At our locations at the High Tech Campus in Eindhoven and Brightlands Chemelot Campus in Geleen, we house facilities for material synthesis and preparation, processing and characterization and performance validation. Key examples include lab and pilot scale equipment for processing of polymers and composites, including 3D printers, glass coaters, and a gas exposure system for the performance validation of chemical sensors. An important base of our activities is the transfer of academic research into valuable applications. Together with Hasselt University, for instance, we developed ruthenium nanoparticles as plasmonic catalysts for the sunlight-powered conversion of CO2 to CH4. With Eindhoven University of Technology, meanwhile, we realised a breakthrough multi-cyclic stable thermochemical material with a high energy density that, together with a patented closed-loop reactor concept, will enable a loss-free and highly efficient heat battery concept. Within the next 4 years, we aim to strengthen and further develop in our focus areas. We will establish a spin-off company to valorise our heat battery concept and expand our activities in the area of sunlight-powered chemical processes. Other plans include scale-up of glass coatings for windows and solar panels, development of advanced thermoplastic composites for automotive and aerospace, and diversification of our chemical sensing technologies from geoenergy into other application areas like environmental sensing. Furthermore, we are exploring whether the competencies and infrastructure built up for fossil fuel research can be applied to subsurface topics aligned with the energy transition, such as hydrogen storage and carbon capture and storage. Moreover, we expect the SEED program's circular packaging and photoelectrochemical water splitting to grow and potentially develop into independent technology programs. With all these developments in-house, we expect to play a key role at the interface of the energy and materials transitions. In conclusion, Material Solutions makes excellent use of its integration in the high-tech ecosystem in Eindhoven and the chemistry ecosystem in Geleen. By combining expertise and partners from each of these, we are capable of developing the best solutions to facilitate and accelerate the transition towards a sustainable society, which can thrive within natural, ecological boundaries.